is proud to announce a major concert event brought to you by the Fillmore New Orleans Legendary Concert Venue.
Ladies and gentlemen, South African hip-hop legends, Dar Atwood. Only at the Fillmore, New Orleans. Incredible. September 26th. MHOG Podcast. One of the most interesting concert experiences you will have all year long. Brought to you by the Fillmore, New Orleans, and the Metalhead of God. September 26th. Be there. Get your tickets before this is all sold out. What an amazing stage performance you will witness from a band that has sparked controversy all over the world. Get those tickets at livenation.com, thefillmorenewOrleans.com, or go to the Metal Hand of God podcast, that's the M-H-O-G podcast.com. Click on the links, it will take you to ticket sales. September 26th. Be there.
You right next to me. Give them nothing, but take from them everything.
And welcome back to the Metal Hand of God podcast. I am your host, Wayne, and that gentleman on the other side of the phone is...
I'm the rum guy.
See, aren't you happy today? I didn't go into like this huge spiel about who you were.
Yeah, but you're still you're backpedaling to go ahead and doing it. Aren't
I was. Yes, I was.
I
was.
I know you are. Yeah, moving on.
So anyway, today we have with us very special guests. We have two actually sitting right there. Yeah,
one veteran now.
Yeah, she's been on the show already, Miss Tiffany Manning. How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys? Great to be back.
You know, hot and sweaty, but okay, because I don't have air conditioning in my room right now.
Yeah,
it sucks.
Oh. But what about y'all? You look like, where are you at? We're seeing you on camera. You're outside, huh? Is it? Speaking of no AC.
Yes. Yes. Oh, it's not terrible. It's not too bad. We're sitting out here with my dog. My dog's not a circus dog, though. All he does is eat plastic. That's his trick.
That's a good trick, as long as he can pass it back out.
You know, that's definitely the trick. Yeah. So, I don't know if it's that entertaining, but yeah.
We'll set it on fire. Then it's
entertaining. Then it's entertaining. Fire always makes it entertaining.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Just make sure it's out first. Yeah.
No. Yeah.
Oh my goodness. So ladies, what have you two been up to?
Hold on, she has to introduce herself. Hadn't even said her name yet.
I'm sorry. I thought you introduced both of them already.
No.
I'm so sorry.
And I know I'm going to screw this name up because I always do. Every name.
Oh, you do. Yeah. That's why I thought you did it right.
No. I didn't. I was afraid of the name. Zarina Hellfire, correct?
She did it perfect, yes. And my nickname lately has been Z. So it's whatever is easier, Zarina or Z.
Nice. And we did a little bit of research on you, and I saw that you're from down here in New Orleans.
Yes. Homes.
Yeah. Like we were saying, like we actually know some of the same people you guys do. Actually, Zena Zeitgeist and
Remy D
have both been on the show already.
Lydia Treats.
Yeah, she's been on the show.
I miss them. I perform with them quite often, or I did when Lydia was in town. But yeah,
she's great. Lydia's great.
Oh, that's awesome. It's like family. It's a family reunion.
Yeah.
Well, what got you? You're down. Where are you at right now? You're down in Florida, right?
We are in the parking lot. Yeah,
Gurney Mills.
Yeah, we're in Gurney Mills in the Value City Furniture parking lot.
Yep.
So we're okay. We're Illinois.
Oh, Illinois. Wow.
Not Florida, Rum. Illinois.
Well, I was just going off what I saw because I thought you might be down in Florida at this time. But, yeah, up in Illinois. Wow, you guys you really travel quite a bit, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Every week.
How long does the traveling go for? I mean, do you guys get a break at all? Do you get to stay in one place for a while at all or no?
We get a break at Christmas.
Yeah. I think it's 11 months out of the year we travel.
Wow. Wow. That's dedication now. That's hard. People probably don't realize how much traveling's involved. That's quite a bit. Because I knew when you guys were doing the show in New Orleans, I know that was nonstop. You were doing pretty much, how many nights? It was almost every night there for almost 2 weeks or quite a bit anyway.
I think it was at least 5 or 6 nights.
Yeah.
It just seemed like it was just going on forever, though. I mean, yeah. It was nonstop. And then you were picked up and moved to another city. That's a hard way to do it. But you guys seem to do it well. And I feel bad because I missed the show because I'm up here. I'm up in North Carolina. Wayne got to see the show.
I did.
And he said it was amazing.
It's fun. I just jumped on board in St. Louis, which is about a little month ago, and I love it. It's because I do burlesque and sideshow at home, and I do a lot of clowning, and I have my own shows that I produce and I do. And it's like, I just fit right in. It's like, oh, except doing it a little bit more than 3 times a week. But
right.
I love it. It's a lot of fun. I love it.
So do you run in, and both of you, this is for both of you, and I'm sure Wayne asked this question before, but I'm going to ask it again. You do the clowning. I know it's effective for a lot of people, but you do get a lot of people that are really freaked out with clowns, don't you?
Yes, I do. People are absolutely terrified. It's really strange. I've never been scared of clowns, but I kind of grew up watching horror, you know, from the 70s and 80s.
Sure.
So I'm not really scared of anything, especially not clowns, but people are absolutely terrified when I put the clown on. And you know, Tiffany's a pro, man. Like, she'll just come out of nowhere and people just lose their shit.
You can say whatever you want on this show, it's okay, you know.
You were pissing up a storm last time. Okay. I was on.
You can say shit, fuck, it don't matter, you know, it's okay.
But I mean, you guys, I've seen your makeup on your website, both of you, and you guys do take it to a whole new level when it comes to taking the clown look. You can really see I can remember, especially from the 60s, like you said, 60 through the 70s, the scary clown thing really became its own entity.
Yeah, it was more prevalent. It became bigger.
Yeah, in the movies and when it was hitting the screens. And wow, you guys really do take it to a new level, though. It can be kind of terrifying. I was never scared of clowns until, my neighbor was a clown, but he was a scary guy, whether he had the makeup on or not.
I've had a few of those.
Mommy,
why does he have a tear on his face?
Well, he was a weird dude. He was kind of, but I mean, that was just him. He was just a weird dude. But yeah, he did a lot of traveling and stuff. But yeah, he was just an angry guy.
He was an angry clown. Guy.
Yeah, he was angry all the time. Then he put his clown makeup on, and then I just realized who they made those movies for. It was that guy.
Next, so John strange. Wayne Gacy.
John Wayne Gacy, yeah.
Because he always had the big smile on his face, and inside, I know he just wanted to hurt me.
Did you live next to John Wayne Gacy? I mean, that's what it sounds like.
He was, I mean, his outfit, terrifying, man. He wore this He wore this purple, like satin suit, trimmed out in black with like diamond pattern all over it. And he had the shoes and he had the, oh my gosh, I remember him. And we lived out in the middle of nowhere country. So when this guy got dressed up like a clown and he had a few drinks in him and decided to walk down the dirt road, it was a horror movie. This guy was terrifying the neighborhood.
They should eat the horror movie out of your life.
They should.
We actually have, because my folks used to have a one of the old, the Super 8 movie projectors, or the recorders.
Yeah,
the
old
film in.
Yeah.
Yeah, they didn't have, we didn't have the microphone. It just filmed everything without sound.
That's scary.
But there's actually footage of this guy walking up the street dressed like a clown, and I always wanted to get that section of him walking up a clown because it was so classic.
We need that.
You know?
That is so creepy.
Sorry, yeah, the barking dogs. We're outside, and it's my dog, the neighbor's dog, and I apologize.
No, don't worry about that. That's okay. Look. Good. Like one of our old hosts, he used to come on all the time, and like anytime the doorbell would ring at his house, you would hear like six of these little yappy dogs running around. I'm like, oh, somebody's at your door, you know.
That's the best doorbell ever.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. So you guys are on a break today, since I was told that you guys actually are doing so well that y'all had to add another show.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. No, we're super pumped. Today is our off day.
We're super pumped. We are tired, but we are pumped. We're glad to be doing so well.
Yeah.
And seeing all the people and entertaining all the people. Today's our off day, so definitely. Yeah,
that's pretty cool, man. Like when Sarah, when she emailed me and said, "Hey, do you guys really think you can move the show because we had to add one?" I was like, yeah, I think so. In fact, it came at the right about time because we are now starting to switch to Tuesdays to record. Normally it was Wednesdays, but he has stuff to do, so now we're moving our days anyway. So it kind of helped us get in that groove.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. They added a Wednesday show, which is actually tomorrow at 7:30. So if you guys want to come out.
Yeah.
I really wish I could.
So just fly up here.
Yeah.
We'll come up. We'll get all the people together. And yeah.
How long does it take you guys to get like a full trip, full tour? I mean, where do you know ahead of time pretty much the direction you guys are going until you get back to a certain state again? Or how does that work for you?
We're not really sure because we both just are like, we're like the newest people here.
Okay.
So we're not exactly sure, but normally when a customer's like, "When are you guys coming back to our state again?" We normally just say like, you know, probably next year.
Because
I think that's when we just revisit everywhere we go back around.
Oh, okay. Well, that makes sense. That makes sense.
Well, I really, you know, I hope you guys do come back over here because I'll go to it again because it was great. I enjoyed the hell out of it.
Oh, cool. Thanks. Yeah, it's a fun show. I don't think I've ever done a scary Cirque. I've done a lot of haunted houses, a lot of burlesque and carnival shows, but never like a scary circus.
Well, what
it's pretty cool.
In your opinion, since you've done these before, I mean, tell us the difference. What do you see is the main, I mean, I can visualize what the difference would be, but in your words, I mean, what is the big difference between this type of atmosphere compared to, say, the carnival side of it?
Sandwiches.
Sandwiches. Sandwiches. There's the budget's totally different. I mean, the professionalism is on another level. I've worked with a lot of great pros, you know, over my time being a performer the past 15 years, but these guys are next level and everyone's top notch. It's amazing. Just the lighting system alone that they use for this production is amazing. The tents, it's just next level.
It's amazing. All atmosphere. Everything's atmosphere.
It really is. And the performers are, I mean, we've got these gymnasts from Russia and they're just phenomenal. I mean, they're adorable and cute and they're kind of like klutzy, like on the ground, but they're in the right. air and they turn into magical beings. And it's amazing. And yeah, the ladies that we have that are dancers and burlesque and they just are hypnotic. I mean, it's just, the production itself is amazing. It's just, you know, I'm used to like a old school you know, carnival sideshow.
Sure. Right, right.
Productions, you know, like, all right, we're gonna take over this bar and
yeah, exactly.
We all have a good time. Yeah, but it's like, and then this is just next level, and it's amazing.
Next level, next dimension.
Yeah, next dimension. That's for sure.
Do you see that also in the people's faces that you're seeing as they're coming in? Do you see this reaction? It's like, I was not expecting this
yes.
much.
That is a definite. They have, like, you know, they love to, like, we're the first thing that people see. We just scare the crap out of them, and it's.
Whoa!
It's great.
We even got one of our heroes coming up now. One of our acrobats.
Yep.
Nice.
Go home. You're drunk.
I know. I'm drunk. Anyway, no, not really. No, it's just everyone's. It's a next level, and the people that come in, I love to see their faces because they're just. It's amazing.
I could tell you when I went, I was like, you know, blown away by how large the set was and things like that. Because, you know, I had they were gracious enough to give me press access. So me and my wife went through and I got to go actually stand on the stage and go see a little more than most people. So it was very cool.
Right. No, it's, there's so much that goes on in prep all the time. It's because everyone's always practicing and always trying to upgrade our costumes and our makeup to next level, you know.
Sure.
Convention stuff. So
it shows.
Yeah,
I mean, there's really probably no time to really take off when you or and stop, because you would have to keep going through the moves and the motions, just basically muscle memory alone. You'd have to get used to it and just make it like it's like you're breathing it every day until, you know, until it just becomes second nature, and then you just got to do it, you know.
I know,
you got to live the character, basically live the character every day, every time you put that makeup on or that costume on, and boom, that you're that person.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened. I'm going to give you the tip right now, and I'm going to put the circus dog in the trailer.
Sorry.
Okay.
No problem. Well, while everybody's going to be putting up the circus dog, we can take this moment to take a break and go with our newest segment that we're about to air. It's something very new. Past guest Ricky Morales is doing something very cool, and I want you guys to check it out. It's called Zeroed In. It's all about him helping out the music scene and doing things for the scene. So go ahead and check out this segment right here.
Leaving behind you a wilderness of misery and hatred, because you will find no horizon.
That's right, it's time for Zeroed In with Ricky Morales.
Hey guys, welcome to the first episode of Zeroed In on the MHOG Podcast. Today, I'll be talking to you about 5 tips that will hopefully help you find success in your music career. Number 1, spend money on your band. Whether you dump that into marketing or production is both up to you, but at the end of the day, if you aren't spending money on your project, nobody will. Your friends and fans can hear the amount of money you spend on your project, so why will they care if it looks like you didn't care? I see so many releases just fall flat because so many artists think they're just good enough and won't drop a dime on marketing and expect to get a nice turnaround. And just as well, I see bands drop no money on the project at all and call it the best thing ever, which frankly, both approaches are stupid. Drop money on your band. It'll take you a whole lot farther than you can even begin to imagine. Number 2, stop saying stupid shit. You're in a local band. You're not some huge band that's existed since the 80s. Who cares what they say at this point? But that doesn't mean you get a free pass to say anything you want. If you want to say shit and it pisses off regular concert goers, you're fucked, period. Yeah, I know. Blah, blah, blah. We're adults. We should be able to say whatever we want. Freedom of speech. Freedom of speech is not freedom from consequence. In the entertainment industry, if you're trying to rise, you won't if you piss the people off that help you rise. that small minority that you may have pissed off yesterday, it can grow overnight while you're not looking. It can devastate you. I've seen it happen to locals, even just in jest, and it fucking sucks. And if you're actually saying stupid shit and you mean those stupid things, people aren't going to associate with you or your band. I don't go to a lot of shows because I don't want to be associated with that shit, and I know a lot of people who don't go to people's shows because they say stupid shit, and they don't want to be associated with that. So, save yourself the trouble. Don't say stupid shit. Number 3. Watch commercials. This one's going to sound really silly, but on the marketing side of things, you should really learn how ads are targeted and how you can utilize what the best marketing firms are doing. Marketing can take you from no one to someone overnight if your product is dressed properly. Ads obviously come in many formats, and it's best to understand what works best for your audience and your brand so you can always utilize what works best for you. And don't be afraid to experiment. A $5 ad can teach you a lot if you pay attention to the metrics of it. Number 4. Don't bullshit other artists. This one will come as a shock to many of you, but we can all see that you're bullshit, so don't try to bullshit your fellow artists. If they feel that you're feeding them shit, they'll make sure other artists know about this. The best way to grow is to foster an atmosphere of transparency. You don't need to tell everyone your deepest, darkest secrets, by any means. Just don't lie or try to manipulate people. It really goes a long way. I can't even begin to count on one hand how many times I've been lied to or manipulated by other artists in the local community. But you have to move past it, of course, but don't forget, because these people are going to continue to try to manipulate you, use you, feed you any information they can to get a leg up on you. Just because the entertainment industry is a competitive industry doesn't mean we need to compete against each other. We're already having a hard enough time competing against ourselves. We really shouldn't be like pushing against each other. We should be helping each other grow. And the best way to grow is to further encourage other artists as opposed to manipulating them. Not everyone is a means to an end, and not everything needs to be cutthroat. We can all make it together, and you don't need to bullshit your friends, your family, anyone to make it in the industry. The best way is to be honest. Honesty goes a long way. Practice it sometimes. So worth it. Number 5, and this is a big one for me. This is something that I have held onto for most of my musical career. It's something that has helped me stand out among my peers, and I really wish others did it. Do what your influences have done. I know it seems like a no-brainer, and you might be thinking, well, I already do that. I don't necessarily mean musically, because just because you're doing what they're doing musically doesn't mean you're doing what they're doing marketing-wise, which is really important. What made them huge can help you. Take what they did and market it for 2019, 2020. Those things worked then. They can work for you just as well. It's super important to not just let your influences be influences musically. Their look, their vibe, everything. Take all of that. All of that will take you so far. Music is just a single part of what makes the industry the industry. You get your look, how people see you, your merchandise, everything. Look at what everyone you look up to has done and emulate that. Make that something you do. I'm not saying by any means rip that off, but be inspired by what helped them grow. Go look back at the history of your favorite band, their merch, their marketing strategies. Watch their interviews. Oh God, I cannot begin to even go over how much watching band interviews has helped me. It's been an it's been a massive instrument in my arsenal for growth, and you should definitely be utilizing it. Interviews are great, not just because it's informative, you know, you get to learn a little bit about that person, which is great. I love learning about who the artists are, but more importantly, you want to know how that artist got into that place of power where they were able to grow so rapidly they lost control. You want that. We all do. And we all need to start looking at our idols on a marketing level if we want to make it in the music industry. Well, that's it for today, guys. This is Zeroed In on the MHOG Podcast, and I will see you next time.
So we're back from that amazing segment. That was very cool.
Yes, that was good. That
Zeroed
was great.
In. I wanted to bring up, Wayne brought it up before, and I saw it on the site too, about the part of the Cirque that uses the, there's the silver and the gold. What are these? The silver and the gold things.
So we're all under the umbrella of Cirque Italia. And the silver is the underwater circus.
Okay.
So, yes, I think there's like a 35,000 gallon tank that they use. And it's, it's magical. It's all underwater acrobats. It's one of the few in the world. I think there's three. And we're fortunate to have one.
Wow.
So that's, I know, it's like, it's amazing. And there, that's the silver unit. And then there's the gold unit, which is, I guess just, it hails for the old traditions of the Cirque. We don't have any live animals. Instead, so it's just all purely aerialists, acrobats, magicians. It's amazing.
Well, that's enough. That's enough stuff. Yeah. I mean, really, with the way the things are today, it would be very difficult, just liability and upkeep and the humane way of keeping the animals. It'd be very difficult to travel with that type of, you know, I mean, you can't really travel with a lot of lions and elephants anymore. It's very difficult.
Yeah, those days are over. So
yeah.
It's all holograms now.
Holograms, yeah.
Ooh,
yeah.
Holograms would be awesome. Put that in the suggestion box. That'd be sweet.
Right. I think there's one circus that actually does that. I don't know which one, but I was, of course, you know,
probably in Japan.
It was amazing. Probably. It was awful.
Man, I just so happened to have this video pop up on my Facebook feed earlier this week. And of course, it's one of the ones that say, don't look if you're disturbed by things. And of course, I'm going to look at everything. So I pop on this video, and there's this guy. He's in a circus, and he's got an anaconda or a boa constrictor. It's a large snake. And he's just holding the snake in the middle of the ring. And you could tell this is definitely not in this country. All right? You could tell it's definitely not in the United States. God only knows where it was. I don't even know if they had running water in this place. So that's how you could tell. And they're like, he's standing there, and then he wraps the snake around him, and he puts his hands up like he's finished the performance. I don't know what performance he was doing. Well,
the I'm gonna die performance, it sounds like.
Pretty close. The snake starts strangulating him, and he's just got his hand up. Like, he keeps putting his hand up, I guess to signal his friends or whatever. Then he just falls down. And, like, no one is coming to his rescue because I think they think it's part of the show.
Oh, my God.
So this poor bastard's laying on the ground getting dead. And these people come hauling at. Finally, they realize that something's going wrong. So they run in there, and they're, like, yanking this big-ass snake off of him, you know? And I'm like, holy shit. He's getting dead.
And what did you do today? Oh, I got dead.
And then, I mean, he was just like a a wet noodle when they picked him up. I don't know if he was.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if he got dead or he was just unconscious. But
man, that's why I don't trust snakes.
That was not a good act.
I don't know. Have you all dealt with snakes before?
I mean, I have. I've got some really talented, amazing friends that dance with snakes. But I've worked with snakes. But snakes, you know, you can't. You got
predict
to know
them.
The snake.
Yes.
Yeah, and not all snakes are show snakes.
Nope.
It's a very special gift to have to, like, all right, this snake, and you train them. You know, because they're danger noodles. And,
yeah, well, that's pretty much. That's my problem. I'd be the guy that have to train the snake and be like, why can't I get the snake that's already trained and knows what it's supposed to do? No, I gotta get the snake that wants to have attitude. You know, the ill-tempered adolescent snake that wants to be. You know, I don't need that in my life.
I owned a very mean snake at one time.
Well, you're a mean person. So
oh, shut up! I am not a mean
only
person.
Only knows what it knows.
I am not a mean person, you jerk. I inherited the snake after Katrina. A policeman.
Well, that wasn't a pet snake. It was a wild snake.
Well, no, the policeman brought. It was definitely a pet snake. It was an albino. A police officer saw it crossing the street, and it was a 9-foot.
Still a wild albino snake.
Burmese, I know. Burmese python.
Yeah.
So he brought it in, and I was like, okay, I guess I'll nurse it back to health. So I took it and
were you bottle feeding it?
Yeah, pretty
did
much.
I let it
latch onto my nipple.
That's nice. You're nipple feeding.
I was breastfeeding a fucking snake.
That's so nice. That paints an amazing picture.
No, it doesn't. It's an awful picture. It's almost like that dude getting dead. It's just terrible.
Oh, it hurts my mind.
But she was, she was not a happy camper. She was a bitch. She was a mean snake.
Oh my gosh! Awful, awful, awful.
Yeah.
You know, it was really probably a wild albino snake.
I don't know.
Dude was just like, this idiot wants this snake. Yeah, I'll give it to you, dude. I don't want it.
Well, he brought it to the vet clinic, so I mean, it was kind of like he said he had 6 of them, and he wasn't in the mood to have another one. So I was like, okay, I'll take it.
I found this pet cobra. Do you want it? Yeah.
Sure, I'll take it.
Sounds like a great idea.
Whatever. Go train your dog.
Yeah. What?
Circus dog.
Yeah, circus dog. Yeah, go teach him to jump on a hoop or something. Jesus.
So, speaking of...
What, Jesus or hoops? Which one?
Jesus and hoops. Speaking of Jesus and hoops, you said you're... Where, in Iowa?
I still like it. We're in Iowa.
Illinois.
Illinois.
It's
a lot like Iowa.
Eight, get it right.
I mean, it has an I.
Yeah.
We are in Gurnee Mills until Sunday.
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 As of late, is there any city that you've been to that you've liked, like that you surprisingly liked? Like, holy cow, I didn't think I'd like this town as much as I did.
Like Gurnee Mills.
I've never been to St. Louis. I really liked St. Louis.
Okay.
I don't get to leave the camp much because I don't have a car, which is kind of good because
you'd never be at the camp.
I like to shop. Like, where did all the money go? Like, I bought stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have a car either, so we don't get to see the cities as much as some of the other people do, but
it's good.
I was about to say,
that could be a good thing, you know? I mean,
yeah. So we get to hone in on what we're like the focus of our craft and the surf. Rather than like, whoa, look at all this stuff we can buy.
I was going to say, there's got to be some shops in certain towns that you've got to just
go to.
Those, the shops like the vintage clothing shops and stuff like that those places are, especially more you get up north, there's quite a few of those shops like that.
Yeah, we're all about the comic book stores.
Yeah, we're nerds, comic books.
Comic book stores, that's what I'm talking about. In fact, the guy who had the snake video, he owns a comic book store down here.
Oh no! Yeah, Danger Noodle Comics.
Calling you out there, sorry. Tim. Calling you out.
A great company. Danger Noodle Comics.
Oh, so much! I love it.
Hey, what's up? Get Dead Comics. That's what I'm gonna name mine. The guy's getting dead.
Get dead.
Jesus Christ. So what's the newest comic you guys have been looking for or checking out?
I'm always on the hunt for, I love anything X-Men, so
nice.
I'm always on the comics.
Lady Death.
Oh, cool.
I love Lady Death and Preacher.
Yes.
Last season of Preacher on the TV show this year.
Yeah, it's the last season that's coming out. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Though, like, I mean, really, I mean, if you sit down and read the comic and you compare it to the TV show, it's like, it's apples Night and Day. Oranges. Oh, yeah. They couldn't do what they did in the comic book on TV. They would have been shut down right away.
Right.
I mean, they got close to some of the things, but I mean, you can't hold a candle to that comic book. Preacher's pretty, by far incredible.
It got pretty intense, though. It was a surprise what they were able to get away with on the show, though.
I agree, but still.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of people were angry with them even trying it, but I think
they did their best. They should have did Preacher movies, if you really want to know.
But,
my opinion.
When they do stuff like this, in my opinion, when they do stuff like the comic book to TV show type of thing, I think it's kind of good and a lot of people were against it, but at least it's bringing the idea and showing, like, hey, there's this comic book based on a comic, and it gets people going, oh, shit, that was a comic book? Yeah, let me go try the books.
Yeah, there's other things out there besides Superman and Batman, you know.
Yeah, like, I mean, it was the Arrow. A lot of people didn't know what the Arrow was until it came out on TV.
I know.
Right.
Yeah.
No, that's so true.
It's good. I mean, it's weird that that type of the comic book culture, it took so long really to catch on mainstream, as I'm going to call it mainstream now. I mean, they tried it in the 70s, but you had the really great TV shows like the original Flash that was utter crap.
Right.
The original Captain America was
terrible.
Was awful.
The live action Spider-Man. Holy crap.
What about Aquaman? My gosh, was horrible.
But you know, we were little kids, man, so that was like the coolest thing in the world.
it was this awful, awful junk, dude.
You know what's really weird is, like, today I still talk to people and they don't even realize that The Walking Dead is a comic book. They think it's a TV show.
It's like, where have y'all been?
Right. I'm kind of disappointed that Robert Kirkman was kind of such a douche about this, and I don't know if y'all know, but the last episode, issue of The Walking Dead was released last week, and like he completely and he didn't announce it till the day of the release that this is it, there's no more.
Wow, that I did not know.
Yeah, he's like, okay, I'm done. That was the last issue.
Well, I'm really kind of surprised that they took it as far as they were able to take that show.
Oh no, the show is still going. He's making so
the
much
shows.
Yeah, he's making so much money on the show. That's going. He's got at least two more seasons slated for the show, and he's got three movies coming out for the show.
Oh, it's just weird. Now it's just getting
weird. And he's actually got another spinoff coming out. So
I don't know what more. No, I know it's like
still
more dead.
Walking,
yeah, right, right, yeah. You got
dead or tired. Now we did.
No.
Oh wait. Put it. Make
dead.
Him.
He's
yeah, right.
It's gonna be tired, getting right? Dead.
They can't get much more that's dead.
That's the new episode. The new season's getting dead.
Add fine.
Watch out for snakes. Snakes will choke you. You are getting dead.
Well, if they start a really scary clown TV show, you guys need to get on board with that.
Right?
Yeah, we're there. Yes.
Did you? What is that that new movie coming out, Wayne? Clown movie.
It's the sequel to Terrorizer. You talking about?
Yes.
Yeah, that's only one clown. That's Art the Clown. In fact, he's actually going to be on the show at the end of the month. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, he's coming on the show.
If you haven't seen
that, looks like amazing.
Yeah, if you haven't seen Terrorizer, check it out. It's a really good clown film.
I have not.
It's a cool film. Art the Clown is actually going to be on our show, which is a very nice guy. Definitely, for sure. And
from a clown and a half to another.
and if you guys like clown movies, of course, you should check out our buddy Billy Pond's film, Circus of the Dead. Billy's like one of our really good friends. He's been on the show lots of times, and he did the song, movie called Circus of the Dead. And if you get a chance, y'all should check it out. It's very, very good.
And Doll Boy.
Oh, yeah, he did Doll Boy, too. That's another good one. And he's working on his new film, which is called Cowboys from Hell.
I think I know a few of those.
Definitely will check it out.
It's a real life thriller.
Yep.
I bet. Yeehaw.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, gosh. So, ladies, well, if you don't mind, we're going to take a quick commercial break right here, and then we'll be right back. Funko Pop Culture.
Funko Pop Culture. A brand new store. Amazing collectibles you need to check out. North Shore Pop Culture Collectibles, specializing in all things Funko.
Funko Pop Culture.
Buy, sell, or trade. North Shore Pop Culture Collectibles is the place for serious collectors. And when they say specializing in all things Funko, they're not kidding. This inventory is massive.
So much stuff!
So many items at North Shore Pop Culture Collectibles, you never know what you're going to find. You may find another gem you weren't even looking for. So don't forget to call or stop by North Shore Pop Culture Collectibles, specializing in all things Funko. Located at 1394 Corporate Square Boulevard, Slidell, Louisiana, 70458. Or call 985-265-4279. Check them out! It's Funko! It's pop culture. You can't go wrong.
Funko Pop Culture.
All right, guys, we're back from this amazing commercial break, and we're with these two young ladies here. You guys want to, tell everybody where they can find your, you know, all your social media stuff and everything, where they can follow y'all, where you can get some plugs in there, and maybe, you know, get some stuff where people can come out to see the shows. You know, they may not know you're in town, that kind of thing.
Yeah, just look us up on Instagram at Paranormal Cirque. And then on Facebook, the same Paranormal Cirque. We're going to be here at Gurney Mills in the Value City Furniture parking lot from tomorrow through Sunday. So tomorrow's show starts at 7:30. Get here early, though, so you can enjoy the pre-show, come hang out. And you can also get $5 off if you type in. You can also buy your tickets online if you use this code $5OFF. And get $5 off on any price tickets.
Cool.
And we have two shows going on Saturday and Sunday. The first show starts at 5:30 on Saturday and 9:30. And then Sunday we have our matinee show that starts at 4:30. And then the next one at 8:30. Now, those are our times, but we always suggest that you get here early. Come get your popcorn and your drink on. And come enjoy the pre-show. It's a lot of fun.
It sounds like it's going to be a blast. I can't wait to be able to go to it next time you guys are close to me.
I have to say.
Anywhere in North Carolina, that'd be great.
The pre-show is fantastic. It's fun. It's a blast.
Definitely.
Awesome, yeah.
Yeah, come check us out. And you can find me on Instagram at T-Rex Talents. And you can find Zarina.
Yep, Zarina_Hellfire. There's only one of me on Facebook and Instagram. So follow us, follow the circus. It's lots of fun. Have a good time. I love it.
And we post updates for Paranormal Cirque on there, too. I post updates for Paranormal Cirque on my Facebook page, T-Rex Talents also. It's the same as the Instagram and Twitter. So definitely hit us up. And any information you need to know, we'll let you know. And we'll be headed to Wisconsin next.
Yep.
So keep a lookout for us.
Hell yeah.
Sweet. Well, ladies, thank you so much for talking with us and taking the time on your day off or your time off. I know you all are exhausted, but this has been fun. It's been really good.
Yeah, it's been a good
enjoyed
show.
It.
Awesome.
We enjoyed it, too.
Yeah, thanks.
Good luck.
Yes.
So, all right. Well, you guys enjoy the rest of your night off or your day off or whatever time it is out there. I'm not really sure.
We don't know.
It all blurs together.
And hopefully we can get you guys back on again sometime.
Yeah, definitely. That'd be great.
Awesome. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. I was your host, Wayne.
I'm the rum guy.
And remember, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to keep it metal! Don't get dead. Don't get dead. Don't get dead.
Adieu, parting is such sweet sorrow.
Go ahead and run. Run home and cry to mama.
Get the fuck out.
Okay then. That's it.